I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.
And before this video starts, I just want to give a big shout out to Pokemonlation. He's making the background for this series, and you'll definitely notice it in this video, and you'll know what I'm talking about. Though there is a little typo in it, and hopefully in the next few days, he'll fix it, and it'll be better. So without further ado, here is episode 3 of Let's Play Pokemon Light Platinum.
Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Pokemon Light Platinum for the Game Boy Advance. In last episode, we got Flame, our level 10 now, Charmander, so you've grown quite a bit just from that one trainer, so you could see him, and actually learned Ember, which might help us along our journey. So, we didn't do much last episode, although we did beat Team Steamin there after us. So, in this episode, we're just going to be making our way up here with the Zephyr region. So, I repeat that. So, you could see a Bidoof. I love how, like, it's like all the regions uniting in this one amazing game. So, let's go quickly do this battle. I'll kind of chase through this. Look like a beginner. Prepare to fight like an experienced trainer. So let's go ahead and see if we could take him down. And there's just a youngster. And it's youngster Juan. I think that's how you pronounce it. So he'll send out level 4 Poochyena. We should easily be able to take that down with Ember. Let's see how much Ember does. And that will take it down. So that's pretty good. Flame will probably grow to level 11. And yes, Flame has grown to level 11. So Inkster 1 will send out Pidgey. Let's send another Ember and see how much that does. It is level 5. That doesn't stop this as we take it down also. So Flame is going kind of quickly in this, which I kind of like, which is going to help us. So I'm going to see if there's any good Pokemon that you can use in the wild. Usually at in the beginning of the game, there's not much Pokemon you can get. Except in the center region, you actually can get Sphinx. Sorry, I forgot what it was for some reason. So here we see a Blitzel, which the sprite, it kind of like pops out in a weird way. It's kind of hard to describe it though. Even though it's either electric or fire, we still take it down. Let's see if we can one hit KO another Pokemon. And no, yet Spirit actually survives with a bit of health left. Right on red. So it's still a sketch, and this will obviously kill it. Come on now. So we defeated youngster Juan, and we go another level, and yes, we have. So I'm going to go quickly take a look at the Pokemon there in the wild, because I'm just wondering, since like there's all the different regions. Wurmple, tiny bug Pokemon, another. Well, we keep on getting level 2 Wurmples. Yeah, I don't think there's anything here. Okay. I might check out what there is off screen, though. I want you just to be seeing level 2 Wurmples, because that's not what YouTube is about, is what people actually want to see. So there's a little shortcut going to Yellowtown, though. We're actually trying to go above. I don't know what's above here, though. That's what I'm trying to find out. When a Pokemon is poisoned, you should use an antidote to cure it. Here you see an adorable little Starly. Star. I was watching, you saw that you're a Pokemon trainer. I know that Pokemon really like to eat berries, and the best way to get this is a type of fruit. Just use Thief on these small trees, and you'll easily pick up some berries. So that's actually a new technique, which is really cool. And we get the TM Thief. And with that, we can pick up berries. And I'm actually going to be talking to many people in this, because I know from my brother playing this that there's actually some gift Pokemon that you get, and boy, do you get a lot. So we get a level 2 Bidoof for that. It's not much better. We run into a trainer. So once again, I'm just going to fast forward to this. What I've been noticing is that the trainers have a lot of Pokemon. A lot of them are bug, though they are bug catcher trainers. And oh boy, is Flame growing from this. I really wish we had a different Pokemon so we could actually spread the width like our team is growing. I believe there's actually a Savari's zone kind of soon, earlier in the game than other ones are. Sorry, fast forward to that. In Central City, there is a TV radio station that broadcasts radio and TV all over the world. So that's pretty cool. It's kind of like Jubilife City, which is a fun fact. That was actually built in the side of a mountain. For those who don't know, that's in the Sinnoh region, one of my favorite. So here we are in Central City. We actually came back here in episode 1. So here we are back here. This is actually where Empoleon used Rain Dance and where the little statue was and where he defeated Team Steam. And what is your name? Oh, Shinx. Wow, I totally butchered that name earlier. So let's go ahead and check out this radio station because I'm kind of wondering what it's going to be. Yes, I saw Combi in Horror Woods. Look very pretty though, still scared. So this is the radio TV station. And as you learned from that little lad, there's actually a place called In Horrid Woods. Welcome to Central City's radio and TV tower. All the technology inside helps people more and more each day. So it looks like this is closed off. Sorry, Bert. Second floor is temporarily closed. I'm gonna try not to fast forward as much so I can kind of take in the scenery. Though, when things sometimes go slow, I just can't help it. So I'm gonna look for the Pokemon Center, and here we see two people. And this looks really cool. It's actually a bench with a peach on it. And over here might be In Horrid Woods. And it's actually Marfany Lake, and that's where we're supposed to go. So I'm gonna go heal up, and then we'll head over to Marfany Lake. And what's this here? It is the Pokemon Safari Zone. So we get a lot of things thrown at us. And oh my goodness, that Pokemon contest. How much stuff can they pack into one city? Seriously. See, here we can see the Pokemon Center. Looks very good. You have a little station over here. It looks like it would be where the multiplayer thing is. So this looks really cool overall. So let's go kill our Pokemon. And Nurseroy actually has more reddish hair. I don't know if that's just me or not. Brock would definitely notice that. If you don't get it in the anime, Brock really likes Nurseroy, like he has a crush on all the Nurse Joys. I'm not a big fan of the anime, though I used to watch it a lot, like the Sinnoh ones. So let's go ahead and see what they have in the Safari Zone. Safari Zone of Central City. Inside there are many ways to catch Pokemon. He actually said of Central City, so I'm wondering if there's more than one Safari Zone. I know this is actually a very big region. Welcome to the Pokemon Safari Zone. You can go to one of two different environments. Which one will I pick? Let's go Marsh, since we have a fire type. Okay, it costs $500, so that's kind of annoying. So you get three Safari Pokeballs. So let's go outside and see what we can find. So here we are in Marsh Zone, and I like how it adds like a little rain effect. I really like that. So let's see what Pokemon this place has to offer. Hopefully it's at a reasonable level. And this is perfect. Oh my goodness. A Krogun. Watch this just be rare, though. I just want to see what else this place has to offer. And watch the Krogun be like rare. So I'm just going to see what I have to offer here. So, next Pokemon will be Krogunk again. And this is a level 6, so I might as well just take this. And I know I haven't been here for a while, though I know you only get like about 500 steps, so I want to make the most of here. And we have Cotton Croakunk, and I kind of want to make him the next edition of my party. And no, boy, what am I gonna name him? Toxic. I saw his Pokedex entry and I can't think of anything better, so let's nickname him Toxic. Okay, there we go. So we have gotten Toxic. So before this episode goes overboard, let's end our time here. Okay, there you go. Can I retire? Yes, I want to leave. So we'll give the tenant our Pokeballs. See, Safari Balls. And let's see what's going on at Marfini Lake. So now that we have our new team member, Toxic and Flame. So I'm going to put Toxic in front with Flame. And this is actually a customary background, which looks really cool. In the bottom left corner, well, a little above that, there's six Pokeballs, and above the Pokemon entry, there's a Pokeball there, and so it looks really cool. So let's go ahead over to Marfini Lake and see if where Professor Oak is. If you remember, Professor Jasmine told us in the last episode that Professor Oak was waiting for us there. Don't remember what quite he wanted. So there's a trainer bell here. So I'll just fast forward to this and once again commentate it. It looks like this trainer had the same idea as us and also caught a Croagunk at the Safari Zone, which I think is kind of cool. Like how he waited the Pokemon in the Safari Zone. And I know I've been saying like this is cool all episode though. Quite honestly, I'd really suggest this ROM hack. It's just amazing. Now I'm gonna be saying this whole entire Let's Play, so just warn you. So right now I'm just grinding Flame and Toxic so that they can grow some levels. And I have a feeling that something's gonna come up soon. So here we have another trainer. What do you expect? And wait a sec, can he attack? Like, does he have any good moves? Oh, this Croagunk is fighting. That's new. Well, not new to this game, though. I didn't know that. So, Astonish only does 30 damage. Mudslap does 20. Although, Mudslap lowers the opponent's accuracy, which could be helpful. So, let's go on Mudslap and just hope that Stucky will miss on us. So, I need to get Toxic and Tabao more, so he can grow a lot more levels. I'm hoping that he'll grow up pretty much the same rate as Flame, because that'd be a lot more easier. And it turns out Mudslap is actually super effective against Stunky, so that's gonna help a lot here. Although this is just a normal trainer battle, so we killed Stunky about like halfway. And let's see if we can get Stunky down and out. So this will probably put Snunky on red, and nope. This next hit will probably put on red. I'm just gonna fast forward to this because it's gonna take a while. Toxic is only level 7. So we get a lot of experience points from that. Toxic will grow to level 7 and so close to level 8. So just use the same technique and keep on spamming those mud shots. And I was about to attack again. What a lazy trainer I am. Let's add a potion, and that'll almost fully heal Toxic. So let's throw, Mudslap only has 10 power points, so that's pretty annoying. Hopefully Astonish will attack, and let's just switch out to Flame. At this point, Toxic is just about to grow a level. Just throw an Ember and I'll probably kill it. And Toxic is level 8, and Toxic learns Poison Sting. And since it knows that new move, I'll throw Toxic back out. And let's throw Poison Sting. And sorry, I went back to the Pokemon box. So let's see how much poison sting does. With stab attack bonus, might do some damage, though. No, it doesn't. So, since I don't want this battle to go on for a while, I'm just going to fast forward this with flame. So, I'm just going to keep on switching so Toxic can get the experience points he needs. And for Life Plan, I'm actually doing a live commentary. As you can tell, sorry my commentary is a bit shaky, and something big is happening here. So I just want to go restore my Pokemon quickly, so I'll see you guys then. Yeah, guys, I'm back, and I just restored my Pokemon, so now everyone's good. And what's going on here? Here you can see Professor Oak and what looks like a third-gen Gold Sprite. And some Feebas. See, Kenta, Feebas are in season. They appear by thousands at this time of the year. Although they are brave, they rarely attack people and rarely appear at other times. Very interesting, Professor. Thanks for the tip. I think I'll try to catch one. So Kenta is apparently Gold's name. I don't know, like, what the characters' names are. You can see the Feebas jumping. Wow, amazing, Professor. I have fallen in love with these Pokemon. I'll catch one right now. Go Pokeball. Wow. That just happened. Wow, I captured a Feebas. Looks like a good Pokemon. And funny thing is, excluding 5th gen, Feebas are actually very hard to get. What? This Feebas is attacking me. I'll save you, and then we jump in, and we'll get out to attack this mighty Feebas, even though that's basically almost like a Magikarp. So we'll slowly walk over to Feebas and tackle it. So, for some reason, there's like the sandstorm setting. Well, this is actually on the beach, so the Feebas is only level 3, so with the poison sting, you could probably easily take it down. And I don't think Poison Sting does a lot, because it's not doing a lot to the Pokemon that are actually good leveled. How much does it do? Wow, only does 15, so I'd actually be better off using Astonish. So let me use that this time. Switch that. Astonish. Okay, we have defeated the Feebas. Thank you. It's Kyle. Professor Jasmine asked me to tell you that she is doing important research on the creation of the universe and she needs your help. She wants me to show you her results. She's in her lab in Yellowtown. Thank you, Kyle. I'll head there right away. Oh, and this is my nephew, Kenta. Nice to meet you, Kyle. You look like a skilled Pokemon trainer. I hope I'll face you myself one day. I'll say the same thing to you. Well, I'm beyond my way now. Thanks, Kyle. Goodbye. Wow, so Kenta is actually Professor Oak's cousin. Not cousin. I forgot what he said. And Professor Oak's grandson is Gary Oak. And who knows what else. Because I really don't know. So we have done a lot here. So I might as well end the episode here in Central City. So who knows what will happen to Professor Oak. Thank you all for watching for this episode of Let's Play Pokemon Light Planet for the Game Boy Advance. In this episode, we made our way to Central City and caught ourselves a new Pokemon called Toxic, which is actually a Krogunk, as can see here. We also made our way to Marfany Lake and saved Professor Oak from a Feebas and met his cousin and nephew, Kenta. So that's really cool. And in the next episode, we'll see how Professor Oak is doing with Professor Jasmine. Once again, thank you all for watching this episode of Let's Play Pokemon Light Platinum. I am Juniper Gaming, signing out.